I'm here with Kev from Inspiring Games, and we're looking at Legends and Tolls.
Hi there.
So tell us a little bit about the game. What have we got here?
Sure. So last year we came to the expo, and there was a thing called the Wyvern's Lair, where you had to basically pitch your game and see if people liked it. And we went ahead and did that. And a year later, we're now at the 95% finish stage with the cards to actually show the backers. We're just about to go into fulfillment in the next month or so.
Brilliant.
The basic concept is, do you guys play RPGs, board games, everything?
Bit of everything, right. from Magic to Warhammer.
So, the same as a lot of our clients, yeah. But the challenge I've got is I love to roleplay, but don't have the time. Yeah. So what we're trying to do is give you all the depth of an RPG, but with the speed of a card game.
Okay, brilliant.
So the basic concept is, can you play an RPG-like experience, a fairly in-depth one, in about 45 minutes to an hour? Yeah. And the way we do that is, it takes a lot of time, is to split it all down into cards and make the cards do the work for you. So, for example, to build your character, if it was a board game, you'd have a tableau. If it's an RPG, it's a character refugee. In Legends, it's a hero.
Yeah? Yeah.
But what you do is you take any hero you want, okay? They're all gender reversible, okay? So you can have the male or female for any of the characters. There's no classes in the game. You take a hero, you pick a weapon. You can pick any weapon you want from the game as well. There's no restrictions.
Okay.
And you start off with a rough weapon, because this is meant to be like the Vikings. It's like Dark Ages, yeah, grim and gritty. And you put a weapon here and here against this metal slot. You would then take an outfit, any outfit you want, okay? And you'd put this in the backpack here,
along
this way. Finally, you put some of these talents along the bottom. The talents give you abilities that you use during the game.
Okay.
And the weapons, obviously, are for combat. But the talents also, when you take wounds, okay? When you take wounds, you will flip them over, so you lose life and the ability to do stuff.
So your skills degrade as you take more damage.
Exactly right. So, and the way it works is, when you level up in the game, you literally just flip over the card.
Okay.
That's all you have to do. So you're going to get a better version of what you want, rather than a random, thanks mate, I didn't want a mace, you get a better thing. And that's how you build your hero, so that's about 2 minutes work.
Yeah? Okay.
But you keep that throughout the game and you level up and you can play for hours with the same hero.
Are there synergies in the skills and weapons?
Absolutely, so. But the next thing you do is when you go from adventure, you go in your map and it's all, you don't need to use acetate. All the maps, sorry, that's a cave. That's a cave, that's another cave, okay? Rather than drawing an acetate, you build all these together.
Oh, brilliant.
Okay? And every turn, you're in the start, and if there's four of you playing, for example, one person always goes the scout, the guy at the front, one person goes the guard, everybody else is in the middle.
Okay.
Marching order is important, because it impacts whether traps will hit you or not. And it's all about decisions. So if you're in this cave and you've done everything, you're going to choose which exit to go. You'll see both of these are bright, so they're both meant to be brightly lit. It doesn't really matter which way you go. But if you're in this one, they're up there soon. Come on, right, here we go. This is a waterfall, guys. This is a pretty card, I think. Yeah? You can, if you were sneaking around, you probably want to go the dark way, so they can't see you. So the scout, whoever chose to go at the front, chooses the exit. In this case, I'd recommend dark, unless you've already been that way. And then you choose whether to sneak or not. And the built-in time maker, you have roughly about 7 events, roughly, depending on the scenario. And you spend one of these every time you go into a room. But if you want to sneak on the way in, you spend 2.
Right.
That's your time, yeah? It gives you a bonus.
Yeah.
And that is to keep the game chucking along. And if this was the case and you left from this exit and you don't know what you're going to do, you draw this card. The rules are you've got to match up lighting to lighting. So in this case, it doesn't matter, okay? Because they're the same. But if you draw this one, you would clearly do it that way, or that way,
yeah?
You don't want to block yourself in.
Really?
Yeah. So you do that, and then you would roll 3d6, and you'll see, in fact, I'll let you do it.
Okay.
Did you choose to sneak? You tell me. Did you change the time?
Yeah, we'll sneak.
Let's sneak. You spend 2 time, and then roll a dice piece. So that's a bad roll, okay?
Just my luck.
2, 4, 7 from the man. Okay, now 7 plus 2 because you sneaked is a 9, right?
Okay.
You'll see that you came from the dark, so you'll see that the number is lower
because
it's easier from the dark, yeah?
Yeah.
So, in this case, you failed, but you can see the bonus of the plus 2, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Imagine if you'd come from bright, it would have been really hard, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
What you've done is you're now careless for this, and this card here will tell you what to draw. So in this case, it's telling you draw an obstacle. So there's a deck here called an obstacle deck. you draw it, and if you were careless in this case, careless means you triggered the trap.
Right, oh no. Okay.
So, in this case, I'll let you read that out.
So the scouts stumble through a tripwire.
Takes the damage. That was you. So you've just hurt yourself.
But the rest of the party's happy.
It's
fine. Yeah.
In this case, with some of the other traps, it's the guy in the guard that gets
right,
shot.
Okay.
So it's like an RPG.
Well, that's an interesting mechanic then. So you've got to weigh up the options of which way you're going down.
But let's assume also that that might have been take a damage and spend a time.
Yeah.
You then burned another time, and it might be the last one, so it's an event. In this case, it's, well, okay, I've picked up the sewer one, but it might have been bats, sewer gas, which is going to say, do bad stuff. That's what it's going to say, bad stuff. So you don't want to burn through the time that you've got
So generally something bad will happen once you've burnt through your time.
Yeah, usually there's the odd good one, usually bad.
Okay.
And what you do is you go off on your merry adventure through these caves, and there are scenarios in it. There's a cinematic campaign in it, but you can also just, some people just want to play it freeform, which is totally sandbox mode. Totally fine. And you can do without the events if you just want to go for an adventure.
Yeah.
The idea is it's a deck built so that you don't know what's coming next.
Yeah.
It's kind of a mix of an RPG, a board game, Fighting Fantasy Books, video games.
With the game acting as DM.
The game acting as DM, yeah. Does that help explain Legends and
Clubs? That sounds brilliant. So when are you looking to release the game?
So the game went through Kickstarter last year, and we are 95% finished. We just want to go through proofreading and so forth of the cards, and then it should be, we've got a special deal on this weekend at the expo for people that want to get involved with it. Other than that, fulfillment will be about October.
Okay.
And then what I can show you is the back of the is this is the caves and the sewers.
Okay.
Yeah. Which is the north set. But this infogram here, this is all the big reveal for the expo. This is the city that you guys are trying to get into, Dunmaudain, okay?
So brilliant.
The Weeping Caves and the sewers, and then the city goes off this way for miles, yeah? The big reveal is that what we're going to hoping to do next is to go with the Crypts, the Silent Dark, which is underneath this river, yeah? And the Brethren Watch, which is kind of our take on dwarves meets a few other nasties, okay? And the idea is, and you'll be able to see this artwork on the stand, guys, is in the crypts there will be, these are like Stonehenge man from 2000 years ago. Yeah, there's a civil war going on between two different types of undead, and you've got to pick a site in the crypts. And there we go, we have these really, really badass undead creatures. What we did is we researched burial rites in Britain.
Oh,
in
brilliant.
Europe.
Excellent.
And they basically said sometimes that they buried the animals with the humans. So we were like, well, that's a monster waiting to happen, right?
Yeah. Amazing.
And that's what we're doing. And you'll go through in the crypts, you're going to go through these henge gates, which will let you teleport around into fairyland and other parts of the city.
I'm liking the kind of distorted history kind of vibe rather than generic fantasy.
Yeah, it's not generic fantasy, exactly right. We've got to make it anachronistic. There are some, you could have a Greek hoplite with Iron Age man, but
they're all hanging out at the same time, it's fine.
Exactly, but there's some logic to it. This is what the crypts would look like, so that's where these Deifer, the big giants, you're sleeping under here, it's going to come and get you. They worship the stars. And then this is other stuff we're working on here in the Brethren Watch, the dwarvy bit. Yeah, you see a lot of concept work on what's going to meet. I'll let you see probably the best piece of art we've got with us today. This is our Gem Lord.
Very nice.
So it's like they're derived from bats, they're about 4 foot tall, and they cast these enormous avatars using gems. They munch on the gems to make them. So yeah, that's where we're going with it. It's a big
brilliant.
Game.
Excellent. Yeah. Cool, so it looks really, really good. Looking forward to playing it myself. We always end our interviews with a random question.
Go on.
So miniatures and hobby-wise, what's your favourite sprue or miniature? And what's your brew of choice while playing?
Oh my word! a brew of choice. I'm in the flavoured milk territory.
Okay.
Strawberry milk. Yazoo. Yazoo's
that, that's an outlier in the interview today.
And what's brew for miniatures? Oh, I would say probably Blood Bowl. I think it's a
good choice.
I think it's an amazing game. I know that it's been around for a while, but I still think it's an amazing game.
Brilliant. Awesome. Well, thanks a lot, and check out the game.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Cheers. Thanks
for
that.
Cheers.